the other one then while I start working
sure.
on this?
Okay. It's a special delivery, an Osprey baby. Proof of a reintroduction success story. Once common across southern Minnesota, these raptors all but disappeared from the metro due to habitat loss and the widespread use of DDT and other chemicals. But now, thanks to Three Rivers Park District and volunteers from the Twin Cities Osprey Project, there are more than 60 nesting pairs of osprey in the Twin Cities. The reintroduction began in 1984 with 6 transplanted chicks from northern Minnesota. The 5-week-old ospreys are banded with colored leg bands to monitor population expansion and nest behaviors.
Again, takes 2 times. Really hard. There you go.
There! Good job!
The colored bands allow biologists to identify returning birds, including their age, nest selection, and relation to other nesting birds. Blood samples are also collected by removing a few small feathers to gather DNA, which will help researchers understand the lineage of the birds migrating to and from Minnesota. Judy Voigt Englund oversees osprey banding for Three Rivers and has been involved with the program since the very beginning.
Biologists band birds because they want to know information about the birds. They can find out how long a bird has lived, where it has traveled, whether it returns to the same nest or the same feeder year after year. Most of the information that bird banders get is when a bird has died, but this way it allows us to tell who is returned from migration and how old they are just by reading their band with a spotting scope.
Once the poking and prodding is complete, this osprey baby is returned to the nest, a living symbol of what can be accomplished when we band together for conservation.